Here we have three different equations. Each equation has only one unknown, and that's x. And for each one, the question is, what possible values we can assign to x so that the equation is satisfied? For the first equation, it's not too difficult to see that what you want to do is set x equal to 1. What about the second equation? This equation is what is commonly known as a quadratic equation. And there's a formula for the solutions. In general, you can have two different values for x. And what about this third equation here? It's got all kinds of stuff. It has sine of x and e to the x squared. There is no known formula for solving this kind of equation. And in fact, if you try to solve this using some software, it will just give you an approximate solution. But the approximation can be as good as you want. The first kind of equation here is called a linear equation. The second equation, as I mentioned before, is a quadratic equation. And the third equation will use a generic name called nonlinear equation. And quadratic equations are also nonlinear equations. So what is a linear equation? A linear equation has the following form. It's a sum of n terms, where each term is a constant multiplied by a variable. And the right-hand side is again some constant. So here, the xi's with n of them are called variables or unknowns, and the ai's are constants, and so is b. So in the example here, 3x minus 1 equals 2, that's not exactly in this form yet, but we can turn it into that form by adding 1 to both sides. And so this equation, which is equivalent to the equation here, is a linear equation. In subsequent videos, we'll concentrate on linear equations because they are easier to handle. As you can see here, solving a quadratic equation is a bit harder than solving a linear equation. And for a generic equation like this, the third example here, it's not clear what we can do. So we'll start with the easy case of linear equations and try to understand as much as we can.